Welcome back to Let's Code. I'm Chris Biscardi, and today, since my cube map experiment failed, we are going to talk about this little spaceship. Now, as this spaceship goes through the landscape that we created in another video, link in the description if you want to see that, it's being adjusted on the x-axis by some Perlin noise, specifically about 6 octaves of Perlin noise in the same way that we were using them in Nanu many videos ago. So I pulled in a crate called Noise RS, which is the crate that Nanu also uses for its noise generation. And we'll go over exactly what's happening here, but we're using it to adjust both the X and the Y coordinate of the ship. The Y coordinate happening very much smaller and very much more slowly than the X coordinate, but the X coordinate being significantly more visible. And you can see there's no like collision detection or anything happening here. This is all done in shaders, and the ship is actually GLTF, which we'll see how to import. It got much, much easier to do to import GLTF in Bevy 0.8, which isn't quite out yet, but will be soon. So I'm over here in the Noiseland example, and the first thing that I want to show is that I have removed the blue cube that we used to have here from the entire scene. And I've replaced it with this GLTF craft miner. This craft miner is from Kenny's collection, which I'll leave a link to in the description. So GLB is the binary representation of a GLTF file. GLTF is kind of like a smorgasbord of, hey, you have some 3D stuff, whether it's models or animations or whatnot, or entire scenes. You can stick all of those into a GLTF file and just kind of use it as like a transport back and forth. Now, my understanding of this is that step one of using GLTF is kind of deciding what you or how you want to use GLTF. Like I said, you could pack it full of a bunch of models and use all different kinds of models. You can pack it full of animations and a single model and use them to swap between things. Or you could pack it with like an entire scene. So you could use like a GLTF file as the level or a set of levels for some racing game or something like that. In our case, we use the binary representation of a GLTF file, which is called GLB, which is more space efficient and what you should use in production. I didn't go through the effort of having like GLTF in development and GLB in production, but like you could if you wanted to. The other really interesting thing about GLB is that it has this scene zero at the end, and that's how we specify that we want the ship. So I've unpacked this GLB into a GLTF file here. And in VS Code, I have a preview 3D model in my GLTF extension. So if I use that, you can see the ship here. It's not actually the ship we have on the right, but it's one of the other ships that I could have chosen. So you can see it in a couple different places. This is what it would look like by default in 3JS, but that's it. It's just a ship in the scene. And on the left here, we can see some of the JSON file that is GLTF. So right at the bottom, we can see the name Craft Racer. We can see the translation. So I believe the ship is at like 201.5. It's got no rotation and the scale is all one. And then we have the scenes here where we have scene zero. So the way that we access scene zero then, if we go back to the main.rs, is with this hashtag. Why it's a hashtag, I don't know. It seems really weird to me. But we use a little hash here to access it. And in Bevy 0.8, we get a scene bundle, which makes this really easy. So we specify the scene by loading in this asset with the asset loader. Scene 0 specifies which scene that we're using. In this case, the scene refers to the entire ship. So we don't just get like a single model with these GLTF files. As I understand it, we have to construct multiple pipelines to actually render all of the objects that are in a GLTF scene. So that's why our ship is a scene and our ship isn't like a model or something like that, or a mesh. So we spawn that in with the transform. We move it to the left a couple, we move it up so it's above the ground. And then I scale it down a little bit to 0.2 because one turned out to be really big. And we've got the ship and the movable on it like we had in the other example. So we can move it through space manually by pressing forward or back. I'm realizing now that I have left and right bound, so we can move the camera, which is kind of fun, but we don't actually move the ship because the ship is being controlled in another system that we're about to go over. So the only other change in this file is we've got this change position function or system, as it were, in Bevy, where we were before just passing the translation into our WGSL shader. Again, our land vertex shader, so passing the ship position into the shader so we can make it go up and down a little bit as the ship moves. And we've just taken that additional translation. We've made this ship mutable, so the transform specifically mutable. And we've used the noise RS crate to do a multi-stack or a fractal Baryonian motion Perlin noise. So 6 octaves of Perlin noise combined. And we use the Z position, so how far the ship has gone. And we use the seconds since startup. We multiply these by 1/500th and then 1/5000th for the Y position. Now, the Y position is probably a little bit too much. I think that it's a little bit too slow. We don't really see much Y movement here. So we'll probably change that. We could definitely make this something like absolutely too much. So we should see quite a bit of Y movement now. So you can see the ship kind of going up and down, almost like it's being buffeted by a wind current, which I kind of like. I don't know. I haven't really decided exactly what I'm going to do here yet. I just thought it was cool that we could load in this GLTF file. We've got movement on the ship, some automated, some manual. We've got movement on the camera. And you can see how this might turn into something like a Star Fox game or something, you know? That'd be kind of fun. So for each of these positions, because Perlin noise is such that every time it hits a whole number, it will return zero. So if we pass in 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all of the results will be zero. So what we want to do to the Z and what we want to do to the seconds since startup, since seconds is definitely going to be a whole number and Z might be, is we'll multiply them by these kind of coefficients or whatever you want to call them to get pieces of the noise that are more granular. So as we go up on Z, it takes 500 numbers basically to go from 0 to 1. So before we get back to zero, we have to hit 500 of those values. So we do that for X, we do that for Y. For Y, I add 1 and multiply it by 0.2 again. The multiplication is to make it a little bit smaller. The 1.0 is to raise it above the ground so that it never dips below the surface of the plane. But other than that, this just runs and runs and runs and runs and runs. The position still gets thrown into the shader, so the shader can do whatever it's still doing. And then we change it again, and we bounce this thing around like it's getting, you know, buffeted back and forth by wind currents, which is really fun. So again, we use the noise crate here. Basic multi is the version of noise that we're using. Noise function is what allows us to run .get. Because this is Bevy, we can just kind of like basic multi new and insert that as a resource. If we wanted multiple sources of noise, we could do this multiple times, not with just insert resource, but insert resource with maybe a different struct or something like that, that would instantiate multiple noise sources. But that's it for today. I just wanted to share that you can use pieces of things like Nanu. You can get your noise from different crates like Noise RS or wherever you want to get it from. And we can use this in combination with the shaders that we've been creating. So we get this really nice, like almost synth wave landscape, like 80s video game landscape. And the ship itself can, you know, have different effects on it, almost like it's being plopped around by some wind or driving into a strong headwind or something like that, which I find really enjoyable. So I'll probably change up this ship a little bit, maybe apply some different materials to it, maybe make a different ship in Blender or something like that. But we'll see where it goes. I'm hoping to get cube maps done. We do need to wait for a PR to land for cube maps to be a possibility. So I would like this sky to be slightly different here. And maybe we can like turn left and turn right and like go around this field of noise, like landscape, but we'll see. And I will see you in the next video. Have a good one.